We're a Black Conference touring company, and this play, Black Conference, was conceived after reading the book Collective Courage. And it's about in the book, Dr. W.E.B. Du Bois wanted to express how much he supported cooperative economics and wanted a forum to discuss it and educate people on it, but that never really managed to happen in the way that he wanted it to. So this play is as if that conference actually managed to happen. So we have Harlem Renaissance activists like Thurgood Marshall, Richard Wright, Zora Neale Hurston, Gwendolyn Brooks in attendance at this conference. A. Philip Randolph is moderating it with like Ella Baker in attendance as a panelist. And the whole format of the show is done in a way that people who are coming to watch the conference are, it's as if they're joining the conference with the activists who are going to see it. So there's a lot of interaction with these figures of history, and the discussion they have educate people on how to create a cooperative environment or engagement on your own as well.
Hello, my name is Atsimba. I'm part of the Ometeo Domestic Violence Survivors Cooperative. We're here at the big Sancochazo event hosted by Green Workers. We're here because we did the Co-op Academy with Green Workers about a year and a half ago. We graduated and we're here with our business. We sell jewelry and crafts made from upcycled materials, like soda tabs right here. We got a purse. We got paper beads. And this is made out of cork. But yeah. We're also trying to do workshops. Since all of our jewelry is made by domestic violence survivors, we're definitely trying to recruit and provide classes as therapy. Just look up Ometeo, O-M-E-T-E-O-T-L. It's an indigenous name, so that's why it's hard to pronounce. But yeah, thank you.
Hi, my name is Dennis Stanberry. I'm right here because I'm a cooperative member from Green Tree Cooperative. And we are here from Mocha Village. My name is Dennis Stanberry, Ms. Vivian Christie over there. And we are here to really show the Bronx that you can have healthy living, you can have a healthier life, and you can have healthy food. So here at our table today, it's all natural. We've done natural fruits and vegetables, and from our fruits, what's left over, we put it in here. And we've consumed 5 gallons of water already. This is just infusion water. And Mocha Village we have a charitable organization. We do community service, health services in the Bronx, health fair, and we have it once a year. And by popular demand, we want to increase our presence in the Bronx. So we want to start a cooperative in the Bronx to show healthy food, how people can have use the things around them to create healthy snack, so we can increase our status. Hashtag not 62, the Bronx is the unhealthiest borough of all 62 counties in New York State. So we're trying to improve that. And we've tested our project with the Green Workers Cooperative today. And we kind of believe our product is solid because 5 gallons of water, kids came back, and they fill it up, and we're here. We got a lot of leads, people signed up for it. So you can contact us at mochavillage.org. That's M-O-C-H-O-V-I-L-L-A-G-E, mochavillage.org, or mochavillage@gmail.com. Thank you very much. The Bronx on the move. Thank you. Miss Christie, shout them out.
Hey, what's up, what's up?
Great. Brooklyn Community Challenge channel, you are most welcome to spread our gospel. Mocha Village to the world, we are in the Bronx and we are doing great.
The Sancocho is just about ready. So I know some of you your mouths are watering. El Sancocho ya está casi listo. Y la gente están allá, oye, está listo. Is it ready? So it's almost ready. So we're not gonna be eating it yet because there's something that we always do before every sancocho. And folks, get your attention up here. So something we always do before every sancocho is that we do a blessing.
By Freddy, it was two sacred animals, which is the jaguar and the eagle. They're very, very sacred animals in our tradition. So that was the second prayer that we did today. And the last dance that we're gonna do today is the friendship dance. So we ask everybody that's here today to join us. It's a very, very simple dance. We'll guide you through it. So please don't be scared. Let's form a circle here around the drum. As much as possible as we can, hold hands with the dancers, and we'll guide you through the dance, so don't be scared. Ahora vamos a hacer la danza de la amistad para los que nos quieran acompañar, niños, papás, abuelos, todas edades. Es muy simple para seguir, así es de que no tengan miedo. Hay que darle gracias a hoy a lo que nos ha dado la Madrecita Tierra por estar aquí, en este lugar, a este bello jardín. A la comida que vamos a comer muy pronto, hay que dar gracias por todo eso, así de que vengan a acompañarnos a hacer esta danza de la amistad. One, two, three, four. Turn to the left. Turn to the right. Left foot out. Right foot out. Thank you.
Who enjoyed the sancocho? All right, make some noise. Let the people in the buildings know so that they can be here next year if they weren't here tonight, today. Who enjoyed the sancocho? Who loved the meat sancocho? Who loved the vegan sancocho? All right, so I want to introduce you to the brilliant minds and the artful hands and the loving souls that blessed this sancocho all throughout the day and made it possible that we had such deliciousness. I'll introduce you, I welcome you, and I present to you Work Foods.
For those that don't know, Work Foods is a worker cooperative that focuses on plant-based and Dominican food. And we went through the Co-op Academy through Green Worker in fall 2015. And we're really grateful for all the support from that day to today. And we really hope to see you next year. Thank you. Also, hire us for catering, cooking classes, and workshops. WorkFoods.com.
Only 9 years of life behind them, ready to break it down. Barricade.
Much of bringing down, of bringing down the men. Bring me down, cause I want to do the war. Bring me down, 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 bring me down.
I just gonna need everybody's participation, or at least as many people as possible. Voy a necesitar la participación de todo el mundo o la más persona que se pueda. Los niños, hacen la mano. Children, raise your hand. Yeah, I need you in the front. Te necesito aquí en el frente.
Brazo, muñeca de trapo, brazo,
Going to come up, and she is also the eldest person that has come up on the stage, and she is my mother, Zoraida Martes. So Zoraida Martes, give it up for Zoraida Martes coming up to the stage. Te traigo el micrófono. Give it up for my mother, everybody.
Es una big surprise, okay? Porque yo no acostumbro a cantar en público. Yo solamente canto en el baño y en la cocina.
Okay. She signed up.
Mi amor, de un modo diferente, muy nuestro solamente, yo te invito a vivir. Vas a vivir conmigo, vas a soñar conmigo, vas a reír conmigo. Te voy a vestir de mariposas, te voy a regalar el color de las rosas, te voy a llevar a donde nunca llueve, a donde no hace frío, aunque caiga la nieve. Partiremos el pan, la tristeza, los besos, lloraremos los dos, después nos sonreiremos. Y cuando ya no me quieras, cuando venga el olvido, me vas a decir gracias, mi amor, por todo lo vivido. Te voy a vestir de mariposas, te voy a regalar el color de las rosas, te voy a decir. Partiremos el pan, la tristeza, los besos, lloraremos los dos, después nos sonreiremos. Y cuando ya no me quieras, cuando venga el olvido, me vas a decir gracias, mi amor.
Still, I am who I am, for better or worse. I don't have to blend in. I don't have to live a lie. I can't please everyone, and I won't even try. Some call me proud. Others stare at me in alarm. But I am not one to bother, because I am who I am. Thank you.
It's to police brutality. It's called Shades.
Good job.
My favorite color used to be red. I could see in it in the days when my forehead would collide with my brother's face and red would drip from his lip as I rubbed the same on my forehead. Sweltering. Festering. Yeah, whenever I flew into passion or rage, the red would fly over my eyes like a cape in front of a bull. The edges around my vision turned dark and a rosy focus bloomed in the center of my view. Then my favorite became blue, cool and collected. I felt it crash over me like a wave, almost. I was always pressed by it, but never fully depressed, just caught in the undertow of this powerful surge. It always pushed me and pulled me down into its depths, and I would try to make sense of the teenage angst that filled the core of me. I would write poems, you know? Roses are red, violets are blue, I like you. No. I want you. That's not it. I love you. Something like that. Always willing to give love, but too afraid to get love or to love myself. Now, right now, my favorite color is black. And this confuses some people. They say, what, the space around the stars in their bright white light? The shading in a drawing? The shadow in shades? It's not alive, it always fades. It's the background, in between the void. It's called the black hole for a reason. And that's where you misunderstand me. That void is not nothing. What surrounds a star is infinite beside the light. The shadows show that you exist. We call it a void because we know nothing about it, not because it is nothing itself. But I see that nothing mentality every day. God, y'all are just so unruly. You need to stop being so lazy. No wonder that thug got shot. Apparently, a gunshot is the perfect response to this shade or wraith or demon monster. Sometimes it's what I think people see every time someone crosses the street away from me or clutch their bags and eye me up like I did something wrong. Walking, doing, being. Like someone let an animal out of cage, but that is not what I am and that is not who we are. And it blows my mind to think that every time this black meets that white and blue, it ends with red in the streets, from black bodies to black pavements. Those with the shade of me, this permanent black, bleed the same red that I once drew from my brother's lip, and my eyes flood with tears, the same blue that leaves my eyes of the same shade that shot Mike Brown, murdered Tamir Rice, choked Derek Garner. And I feel suffocated, wondering when. When is it my turn to be that terrifying black beast that needs to be laid out on the street? Thank you.
Oxidized iron frames imitate red clay, swarming Bronx landscapes baked in sun rays. Cracked by bitter frost are their earth-tone paints, designed for species preservation, so we call it a fire escape. A treehouse attached to six-story brick frames, a refuge on summer days when heat gets served for dinner and cool breeze is dessert. Windows become portals to the great outdoors and fire escapes hilltops to watch the passing of the day. A penthouse crib where babies play and watch the setting sun separated from the silver moon at double the distance from where it was at high noon. When hydrants sprayed bliss and kids escaped heat through rivers unleashed down white water covered streets. Cooling dark asphalt that sucks the sun from the sky. Passing it off to concrete to make the release to mighty rooftops that unleash the heat from concrete drums dubbed inner city slums. Abandoned by white flight seeking cul-de-sacs and sunlight, monoculture homes and hegemonic lawns, fed by invasive malls with stalls containing crystals, rocks, and fossil shops, shape-shifting weary shoppers into residents of Eden, reaching for a time before the fall, before two-door garages and trips to the mall. So the city becomes a second-rate project for rejects tattered and torn. Habitats are clear-cut for highway projects. Concrete jungle residents forced homeless. Ecological succession takes hold in empty lots, and ghetto visionaries fight the city for garden plots. Just so butterflies can rest their wings in search of the promised land, hidden in urban sand, secrets of a ghetto wonderland, where signs of seeds bud forth from concrete with old men knee-deep in games of dominoes under windows, drinking from roots and culture, where men of the streets avoid the true neighborhood police, mothers on the beat, hawks on windowsills, who at the crack of dawn extend their leaves of coconut palms and embrace the kiss of sunshine that saturates the sky, while their kids tug at the knees, yearning to fly, eager to beat their wings, eager to spread their wings and beat the new breeze along with heartbeats and breakbeats, pumping eagle feathers to cool the urban buffaloes, inspiration for cave paintings tagged by ghetto aboriginals. Around my way, we've got interlocking ecosystems of predator and prey. Too much concrete, not enough shade. But blessed with life, polyrhythms that cut through strife and insights to this life, deeper than the deconstructive thoughts of an academic band, searching for the secrets of this ghetto wonderland.
Please join Omar by the Trump pinata hanging from the tree. He's standing right there. He's the tallest guy amongst the 2 to 4 feet people. And everyone else, we really enjoy you being here. We would really enjoy you helping us clean up. If you see garbage, if you see cups, plates, any basura, please throw it in the garbage. Yes. We are green worker cooperatives. Remember that.
All right. Gabby, get away from
her. Okay. All right, we ready for the piñata breaking? Oh, no. All right, so I want to get one line of people. All right, I'm going to get it back up. Take 5 steps back. All right, take 10 more steps back. All right, so listen. So we're going to do this. This is not just for children. I know some of y'all have some Trump aggression that you want to get out. So we're going to form a line of people that we're going to curve and make a way around here. And so if anyone's after here, you just keep going, all right? All right, so this is your chance. So we're going to have the younger ones go first. And then any adults. So I want everybody in size order.
Luna.
All right, so the smallest ones in the front. The smallest ones in the front. If you're taller, move back. You'll get it. Pero, empezando. Aggression in the community, well, and this is a perfect opportunity to take it out on Trump, who's in town this weekend. Power to the people. All right, you got it? So let's hear it. All right, we're going to swing and...
Power to the people! Power to the people! Power to the people!
All right, so it'll be that, or, and we'll do that, and we'll switch to... Fuera! 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 All right? So, ready?
Fuera! Fuera!
All right, I think y'all are ready. All right. Trump es fácil, no va a salir tan fácil.
Power to the people!
And see, you got it because you got the body, but there's still the head. So there's still more. We haven't finished yet. All right, so if you haven't gone, if you've already gone, afuera, to the side, to the side. So green worker team, come to the stage.
Hi, when I'm not woke boots, I'm the co-op teaching assistant for Green Worker Cooperative.
Hi, I'm the outreach coordinator for Green Worker Cooperative. If you've heard about this, it was probably because of me harassing you. Yeah.
Hey, y'all.
Hello, it was Anon. I'm Shade, I'm the admin coordinator at Green Worker.
Hello, I'm Raven Vargas. I'm the communications coordinator. You could check out a lot of what happened today on our Green Workers Facebook page. You missed on the open mic. Go tonight and check it out. And, you know, tag yourself, please.
My name is Omar Freya. I coordinate the Co-op Academy that folks who've been a part of this have gone through. And so we all are really excited and thankful to have all of you here. So thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí. Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí. Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí. So we have an announcement to make, and I'm going to pass it over to Sade to do the festivities.
3, 2, 1, all right, y'all. So this is the save the date for our first ever social justice holiday market, where we will be featuring our co-ops. If you have a business and you are in the crowd, the application is up, so you can apply. There is a small fee, but please go. It's on November 18th from 2 to 7 at Sweetwater Yoga.
Wow. Which is where?
Oh,
I don't know. 161st Street and Girard Avenue, Sweetwater Dance and Yoga.
So who's going? Awesome. So if you're actually really going, go on our Facebook right now. Take out your phone. Go to our Facebook page and the event is there. Cool?
Everybody's on the phone.
Awesome. You can hit it.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you and have a good night.
Level up.